The last question. What is the ruling on taking pictures using cameras or videos? Does it fall under the definition of it being a picture, as there is khilaf between the scholars?
With regard to the picture taken, Allah الَّذِينَ تَقَرَّبِ إِلَى اللَّهِ عز وجل بِهِ, from that which brings us close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the generality of the impermissibility of pictures, whether it's video or whether it's cameras or otherwise. Now, we say this based on the evidences which have been put forward. If you look at the kalam of the ulama, those who permit it, they permit it due to a haja. They say there's a need for it, so you can do so. But this haja, when you're dealing with that which is impermissible, it has to reach a level where you're being compelled to do so. And when the ulama in the past, this issue came up, there was very little ikhtilaf. In the past, when the issues of pictures came up, they're talking about the pictures which were being used, cameras were being used at that time, there was little khilaf. You find a lot of the fatawa of the ulama were on the same page. But later, as time went on, there were changes in stances with regard to it. But the believer doesn't look at these masail khilafiyah because the ulama have differed, then that's my way out. But you look at the dalil, look at the evidences and the proof which is put forward. If this was something which was clearly permitted, then there wouldn't be this ikhtilaf. And just because it's an ikhtilaf, it doesn't mean it's a tabrir, it becomes permissible because of it. So the evidences that indicate the impermissibility and the generality of this are many. And we just take it as a quick benefit with regard to this. As a person, you may say, what is the proof? What is the proof that indicates the general prohibition of pictures? From that which indicates the general prohibition of pictures in all of their different categories, is if a person, you were to ask them, what is the proof to show that it is impermissible to use marijuana? Anyone know the dalil? What proof do we have to show that marijuana is haram?
It's harm into your body.
Harm? جيد نعم كل مسكر حرام. Every intoxicant is haram. كل مسكر خمر. Every intoxicant is a khamr and every khamr is haram. So they use the generality of kul in this hadith to indicate that an intoxicant, they're haram. General. What is the wording that came in the hadith? Kul. Then we have the hadith of Ibn Abbas, كل مصور في النار. Every picture taker is in the hellfire. يُجْعَلُ لَهُ بِكُلِّ سُورَةٍ صَوَّرَهَا نَفْسًا. He will be, with every picture that they took, a soul will be created for them. فَتُعَذِّبُهُ فِي جَهْنَمٍ. And this will punish him in the hellfire. Now the shahid of this hadith that we wanted, kul comes two times. Kul. Kul musawwar. Every picture taker. Every picture maker, we should say. And we have in the hadith, بِكُلِّ سُورَةٍ. With every picture that he made. So we have kul coming in this hadith. So the generality of kul, when it indicates narcotics, we will apply generally and we will say all narcotics are haram without any exemption, whether it's a tablet, whether it's a plant, whether it's a liquid which is being used. They will say all of it is haram based on the generality of kul. Now when it comes to the pictures though, you will say, what about kullu surah? Every surah, he will be punished with it in the hellfire, every picture, every image. They will say, no, but that's the pictures that were there during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So how do we do istithna? How do we exempt it? This is the complication that arises. How do we exempt the pictures in this era from the generality of kul? Every surah, every picture. But when it comes to narcotics, we generalize it and say, no, every narcotic is haram based on kul. What if a person argues that marijuana is not haram because it wasn't there during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Someone will say, this person must be joking. Hakada? Would anyone take anyone seriously if they were to say that? But when it comes to the pictures, you will say kullu surah, with every picture. But then they'll say no, because there's khilaf. The believer doesn't make his religion revolve around khilaf. You look towards the dalil. And aqal ma yuqal, the least that can be said about this matter is that it's doubtful. And the Prophet ﷺ said, da ma yuribuk ila ma la yuribuk. Leave that which causes you to doubt to that which does not cause you to doubt. فَإِنَّ الصِّدْقَ الطَّمَأْنِينَ وَالْكَذِبَ رِيبًا. For indeed, truthfulness brings tranquility and lying brings about riba, this doubt. So the least that can be said is that it's doubtful. So it's better to leave that which causes you doubt. And if you're propagating knowledge, it's a final point, the person may say, You're propagating knowledge though. So it's permissible because the people are in need of your ilm. Man, this is correct. The people are in need of your ilm. They're not in need of your surah. And when a person is recording, what they're benefiting is not necessarily only your knowledge, but how you look. The matter, if you were to look at the ulama of the past, how many of them we love them. We love them. And we love what they have put forward. We respect them for what they have put forward to Islam. No one knows how they know. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we don't know how he knows. But we love him. And we admire him. And we send salat upon him. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we don't know how he knows. So this image, it doesn't really bring about more than seeing how a person looks, as Al-Bani Rahimahullah mentioned. Wallahu a'lam.
See if the marijuana is used for medical purposes. Yeah. So tablets don't work. Yeah. And a person that's Muslim practicing, and marijuana is the only thing to help him get through his pain. What about that kind of remark there? Could he still use it to help him with the pain, or because the tablets aren't working for him? And the only thing is marijuana that just kind of keeps him back and his body from seizures. What about that?
The ulama mentioned that a person using something which is haram, whether it's alcohol or otherwise, if it's being put into maybe certain medications, this is when it reaches a hadd al-darura, a level of darura, with a shart and a qaid, there is a restriction to this, that there's no other available replacement. So if there's nothing which is available that will replace it, and this is the only way, then al-darura tuqaddar ala qadriha. The necessity is looked at in proportion to what is needed, not to generalize the ruling. But it's highly probable that there are other ways of finding or getting some form of relief from the pain without using that which Allah has made haram.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله